First and foremost, we're going to make sure that we are able to successfully load a plugin on Unity. So we'll call this, I don't know, whatever you want to call this, test for YouTube. So Unity has a set structure for the folders where it goes looking for these DIL files that we're going to create using Visual Studio. So the first thing we're going to do is set up the architect, the hierarchy here. So in assets, create a new folder, and you have to call this plugins. And inside of plugins, you need to create another folder specifically for 64-bit plugins. If you were going to make a 32-bit plugin, you would use x86. Alright, and we're going to go ahead and save this as a new scene. We'll call this scene main. Sure, why not? Cool, so we got pretty much the layout here we want. Let's go ahead and jump into a Visual Studio and start writing the plugin 2017. So this is assuming that you have already downloaded OpenCV and extracted it. I usually extract it to my C drive, like straight there, but extracted it there. And we're going to go ahead and just create a new project. The type of project is important. We're going to use this desktop wizard. We can call this whatever. Project Boredom YouTubers. And this location's kind of arbitrary. Sure, why not? After we go into a desktop project, the Windows desktop project gives us this nice wizard. We're going to use the wizard to select a DIL file to make our lives easier. Giggity, giggity, giggity. Also, included in my links below, I've included the scripts that we're going to be creating here. I'm not going to write them, I'm just going to copy them into here because you know what, I got time for that. But it would help if I remembered what they were called. Math library. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna create a quick DIL file just to test Unity and to make sure that it is capable of reading your DIL files. Believe we're going to do the same for a C file. That one on my okay. If you guys want to go over this real quick, I don't mind. So what's happening is that is weird. Why are you including yourself? Unless, oh. Oops. There you go. That would help. Okay. So So as we all know, headers provide definitions for your class, I'm sorry, for your C files, C++ files, whatever it is. And so what we're doing here is that we're defining this these functions in the header file in a class called functions. And we're going to use this to access our functions here, right? So add, multiply, etc. And then in the CPP file, we're actually implementing the functions by calling the class functions and giving it the method name, and then giving it its actual implementation, defining the namespace math library. Thus, this will all come into play later, but you'll see that it really won't matter. I mean, it does matter, but you'll see it. It gets computer generated, and it won't matter what we call it. Then we have to set things up for Unity. So we're going to go release 64. And so all we have to do is go to build solution. And it's going to generate that deal file. Cool. Gravy. All right. Build succeeded. Zero failed. That's good news. So now we can go over here. Go to that folder, wherever your project is. Mine is in some obscure location. Users, source, repos. And this one's called Project for the YouTubers. It's in the 64 folder under release. You'll find the dill file right there. You're gonna copy this dill file, or you can drag it over into your plugins folder. Cool. Now it's there. If you click on it, you can just use the plugin inspector to look at it, but we don't have to mess with it. For assets, we're going to create your handy dandy scripts folder, scripts, where we're going to create a script, create a C sharp script that will be acting as a interface or interfacing with the C++ library that we just created. So in case for you little youngsters don't know, a dill file stands for a dynamically linked library. The more you know, right? So we're gonna call this C sharp class. I don't know. I don't know. Love hurts. Love stinks. Just kidding. Mucho amor. And it's pretty cool that when you open it from within the editor, within Unity, it opens a separate studio instance, which is pretty convenient, so you don't get lost in the sauce between the two. But of course, Visual Studio likes to take its time. All right, so I also included in the links the contents of this file. We are going to have to change a few things, and I'll show you right now. So, this one was the Unity script. Copy, paste that all in here. Okay, yeah, so this is for the one we're going to do later. So, we have to do some cleaning up here. For example, we're not going to update. That's not the hotkey. We're not going to do that. This is actually going to be add. We're not going to do any of this stuff. Because again, we're just setting up the project for success. So here's a really interesting part, and the part that I wanted to get into. What was the name of the deal? So when you go to DLL import, first you give it the name as a string without the extension, and your entry point is your class name, and then the namespace, and this is the function name. So it's function name, class name, namespace, but it has all these weird characters in between, and you're like, how would I ever know to put that stuff? And it's a good question. I don't know. So I have to use a program, and that's that nifty program made you download. It's called Depends. No, it's not. It's called Dependency Walker. All right. And so what you can do with Dependency Walker is you walk over, JK. You open up your DIL file, and it will tell you this is the entry point for your function, and you can kind of copy them, copy the function name. This is for the add function, add multiply and multiply. That's useful, and it's going to come in handy later when we're debugging the OpenCV stuff and creating a valid DIL file, because it's not going to be as easy as this one, but at least this one's going to prove that our computer is healthy. Our setup is correct? Sure, whatever you want to call it. But yeah, just paste that on there. It ends with a Z. Oh yeah, it does. Cool. So that's our entry point for the add function. I believe the add is an external double that adds two doubles. Double X, double Y. And in here, we're probably going to want to create a test. And the parameters are X and Y. Alright, save that. And now that looks pretty good. Let's go test it in Unity. So here we are in Unity, little spinning circle means it's thinking of something. And for now, let's just create an empty object. We'll throw this on here. Oh, wait, what? Oh, whoops. Yeah, this should be called mucho more. Cool. So we have an empty game object, and we're just gonna drag the script onto there. I'm gonna make my camera solid color, and you'll see in the console that we didn't get any errors. And that's a good sign. If you got errors there, then you did something wrong. And I recommend just starting over. We should have printed this. Oops. Cool. So you're gonna see that it reaches into that C++ code that we compiled into a DIL file, and it executes those functions. We're going to use this technique, same way that plugin that you would buy for $95, to reach into the OpenCV library and write your own custom functions. And it's really simple. So pretty much right now you've got everything you need here, debating whether or not starting a separate project for you. Man, let's just keep it all the same. So over here, yeah, we probably should, huh? Okay, let's make a new project. Project, we'll call this one OpenCV Proj for damn YouTubers. Alright. And then we're gonna also make a DIL out of this. Okay. We're all getting gravy. Now I chose some weird namespaces based on some other stuff, but it really ain't gonna make no difference. So this one's gonna be a little bit more complicated than the little sample one we did, but it's good that we did the sample one. That way, you know, in case you were if you just did the sample one and for whatever reason you got an error, or I don't know, you have some sort of DIL error in Unity, or compile errors, or you were never able to build it in Visual Studio, I recommend that you check yourself before you wreck yourself, because you can't go on without getting that to work. So once you get the deal working in Unity, then we can move on. Okay, let's move on. So the next step here is we're gonna do the same thing, but for OpenCV, and we're gonna test that too. So it's gonna be great. Alright, cool. So the first thing we're gonna do is create a random C file. Call it header file. I believe I called it background subtraction. Cool. And again, in the link description, you will find a handy dandy script that I've included. Call Unity. OpenCV H file. And then on this one would be the OpenCV CPP file. Cool. Save that. And as you can see, you've got a lot of red danger over here. So first, let's set everything up. We want to release. We want 64-bit. Then we're going to right-click our project, go to Properties, and then under C++, in General, this Include directory, that's going to be wherever you have... Oops. Your OpenCV build include, and just copy that path right into the box, hit enter, hit apply, and then our next thing is linker, go to general. Similarly, we're gonna go to build 64-bit VC14, which is backwards compatible with binary compilations of the 2017 stuff. 2017 is backwards compatible with 2015. All right, I'm not gonna do that again. The lib folder where you have your libraries, copy that path into this handy dandy additional library directory. Smack an enter right there, hit apply. Not done yet. And then under input, we need to include right here the name of this one. The one that ends with a D stands for debugging, but we're doing a release version, so we're gonna do the whole thing right here with the extension. So with the extension, hit OK. Does this replacement where it abbreviates everything else, which is why didn't it do that in the first place? But who cares, right? Hit apply, and OK, we're ready to move on. So all the red stuff should have gone away. If your red stuff didn't go away, you probably chose an incorrect folder. So check yourself before you wreck yourself. Let's see where we're at. So if we try to build this now, we're gonna get a lot of love. You see? Build succeeded, but the world's not all rainbows yet. And let me show you why. So if you open up another instance of Dependency Walker, go to open, head over to your project, which we called OpenCV project for the YouTubers. In here, release, we have that dill we just generated. If we look at this dill, it's not going to be pretty like the other one. And there's a reason I didn't close the other one, because I'm going to show you the difference. So, as you can see, you got a lot of red blood out for murder here, and it's complaining about some like super random dill files. This one's for like Internet Explorer, this other one's for like some library that you already have installed. These are just like super random errors. You're not even supposed to sweat it. But if we collapse these windows on the side, or these little trees, you can see that in the one we did before, which didn't have anything special in it. It was all basic C++ Visual Studio stuff. We got these three included builds and no errors, so we didn't have a problem. But now over here, all of a sudden, we include this heap and OpenCV World dill file, and we got all them problems. So if you were to try to open up your deal here, stop running it for a second. Open up your plugins folder and drag in that dill that you just created, which is source repos OpenCV, this one release. If you were to drag this in right here and try to use it, we'll try to use it. Let's use it. Test for YouTubers. Now we can uncomment this stuff that was already here. Uncomment that. We could comment those. And we can comment that. Actually, we need to call that other one. What was it? Instantiate. And then we can uncomment this. And up here, we're gonna need the name of that dill file for both of them. And if we look over this nasty file, then we can see you have to click on the top one in case you lose it. You can see those function entry points. So we'll copy that function name for initialize, which returns a void, which doesn't return anything. And a little ha-ha right there. We also need a, that doesn't look right. Yep, not right at all. There you go. And then we need to do did I do something crazy? What did I do? Oh, there is no semicolon there. Okay, well, that explains that. Anyways, I'm sorry for whoever was watching me do that for the longest time. Delete this. This turns into. I should have just copied the whole thing over. Oh, you're so silly. You know, this is why you YouTubers need to speak up and say something, otherwise, I'd just be here writing a bunch of hocus pocus. Oh, bam! Oh, wait, but those aren't the same. So, I do believe. Then when we compiled it, these changed. I guess we'll find out right here. Oh no, they didn't. So the other one. Yeah, cool. Awesome. And okay, cool. So we have this, and we're like, okay, well, you know, let's go run it in Unity. What do you think Unity's gonna say? Unity's gonna be like, oh yeah, for sure. Oh, this is called something else. What do we call it? Call it this thing. we try to run this right now. Damn, I'm doing pretty poor on time. I'm at my 45-minute mark already. If I hit play, I'm gonna get like Danger Dr. Robinson kind of stuff. So, this thing is saying we have a bug. Oh, right. Whoops. Keep doing that to you. Sorry, script. Alright. Load that there. Hit play. And you can see we got this stuff going on. And if you remember correctly, when we were looking at the dependency walker stuff, we had a bunch of errors. So, hashtag not surprised. And the only difference here is this OpenCV World 340 DIL file. And that's going to be the way we fix this. So, we're going to go over to. OpenCV build 64. 14 bin. You're gonna see that dill right there. You're gonna copy that. Go over to your project assets plugins 64, and right next to your other dill, lay down low. This way, this dill has any dependencies with this guy, according to Dependency Walker. He should be able to get access to whatever he's looking for. And sure enough, there's no render. Oh yeah, so I set this up pretty neat for you guys. Instead of an empty object, go ahead and put it on a plane, put it on a coffin, put it on this thing. Hit play. Oh wait, ooh, I wonder if my webcam's gonna conflict. It did. Here, let me turn my webcam off. That's weird.